good. Alistair? Excellent. So, Alex, you're next. Fantastic. Yes, I started reading the list, but I didn't manage to get all the way through. So yeah, we did. We had a lot of submissions today, which was fantastic. If you weren't chosen, please submit again tomorrow. If you would like your card back so you don't have to write it out again, come and talk to me in the morning tomorrow sometime. I may be a little bit more available because I was frantically working on my workshop up until the last minute all morning today, so you wouldn't have seen me. And we have slides up, so I'm going to hand over to Alistair to tell us how to walk in a straight line.
Great, thanks. Like many of you may have done, I booked my travel here before the timetable was changed and never got around to updating it. So I got here on Thursday evening and found I had Friday morning free. So I used it to test my code. Quick show of hands, has anyone heard of Tom Davies, aka GeoWizard? Cool, a few people. He became a bit famous by walking in straight lines across countries. Norway, Scotland, Wales. Sometimes those walks seemed a little bit tedious. He put videos of them up, and it was a lot of open countryside and empty grassland. So I thought, well, hypothetically, would it be more interesting in a city? I live in London, so I started checking out, well, are there any straight line walks across London? I wrote some Python scripts to help me out with that, trying to find out what would be the straightest line across. There are buildings in the way, which makes it difficult, so you have to give yourself some margin for error, some leeway. And then on the way here, on the train, I thought, why don't I see if this works for Cardiff as well? So I'm going to share with you broadly the algorithm that I used. Firstly, OpenStreetMap already has the boundary of the city of Cardiff in data. Some of that looks like countryside, but it is all Cardiff. And take the ID, that bit, and then this is some of the code. I use the OSMNX Python package, which is brilliant, by Jeff Boeing. If he happens to be here, that would be cool. Forgot to put a box around it. Put the ID there. Just grab a data frame. The package does that for you. Turn the boundary into a polygon. Then you can just give it that polygon and say, give me all the walkable routes, in this case walk. You can also do driving or any public transport. Give me all the routes as a graph connected as a network, which is brilliant. Then I did this to show it to you. That is the graph of all the walkable routes in Cardiff. It does not include motorways, railway tracks, other transport options. It's just pavements, public footpaths, that sort of thing. There's a bit of a gap bottom right. That is Cardiff Bay, the sea. You can't really walk there. Most of us can't, I don't think. And some of the stuff around the outside you can see is quite sparse because it's really the countryside. The next bit of the algorithm's a bit more complex. There are lots of ways to do it. I probably didn't do it the optimal way, but you've got a graph. You just need to find the straightest line in that graph. And I'll give you a second just to take a quick look if you can make out the lines and maybe guess where the straightest line might be. That's it. And from the center line there, that's no more than 100 meters deviation either side. And in the community of straight line walkers, there is a community, that's known as a bronze run. goes all the way up to platinum at 25 meters, which is a really very straight line indeed. I got all that done, actually, in my hotel room, finished it off Thursday evening, and so the last thing to do was system testing. So I walked along that line. had about, I don't know if you can see there, but bus just after 7 a.m. had about 4 hours till the conference started. And some bits were quite difficult. Very difficult. That's the GPS tracker I used just to check I wasn't going off course. And quick skyline of Cardiff. Learned some Welsh and got to the end just in time to come here for the intros on Friday. If you have any questions, yeah, thank you.
Great job. Great job, you too. That was loud, fantastic. So yeah, Alex, if you'd like to get set up. Were you in the first time speaker bucket? So you, two talks today then. Fantastic. Oh, great job. Really good.